Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Today I went to Oxford University. Oxford, over there, there's a Wycliffe Hall in which a good person is every Thursday nearly a seminar is organized. And today the seminar was given by Michael Nazir Ali, a bishop of Church of England from India, from Pakistan, you know. And these bishops, you know, they are so well groomed into their position, like those Pharisees or Sadducees, from the yoke of which Jesus set us free. They don't want to leave their chair, and they don't want to be away. So today I had a chance to ask him a question, that when Jesus died on the cross, the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn from top to bottom. Top mean the temple high priest, bottom mean the village rabbi. So we have to have direct approach to God, as everyone is to give his own account to God. Nobody can give your account. And I asked him, with these dog collar and other thing, you know, you are putting on, so where you stand between man and God? Then he says, yeah, we are just guide, you know. No. Guide, if they are blind guide, they will lead the blind into the pits of sectarian riots, which are they are doing. They are killing people. They are the super vipers. Remember, John the Baptist called those temple priests vipers, because they were making Jew outwardly. When they become Jew outwardly, they renounce their tribal father. When they renounce their tribal father, they become super bastards. So that's why Jesus called them, that your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44, and retorted that we are born of the legitimate parents. Jesus said, what you are saying is true, but by renouncing your tribal father Judah, by Jew, tribal father Judah with Jew, you say bye-bye to your Judah tribe, Judah tribal father. You can't have two tribes, only one tribe. And by doing so, you become super bastard. That's it. And they were annoyed. They want to throw stone at him, you know. So this one also, you know, the bishop, I asked him, can you give my account to God, as the rabbis used to give the account of their congregation? He said, no. Then he opened the Bible and start, I will send you companion Holy Spirit. And I told him, Holy Spirit is common sense. He had no idea. So they are, you know, people clinching to their seats for money. Position, you know, they get big house, everything, you know, comfortable living. And these clerics, they are number one in the job satisfaction. So why should they leave? So you will see, you know, at Jesus, when he was preaching gospel, they were resisting to leave, and they killed Jesus for throwing them away. And you can see with those thrown away priests, how they are sticking to their post. They can't give your account to God, but they won't let you in. They won't. They are like dogs sitting in the manger. And unless you are solitary and you get rid of them, you cannot make progress. You don't need a dog for the priest in the church. He is Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. Judas Iscariot used to steal money from the purse. And that's why Jesus threw him out at the Last Supper. when everybody was sure that he is the one who is a thief. So thieves are not allowed into the Church of God. But they have Church of England headed by Queen. Queen is head of Mammon. And no wonder they glorify soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, as to have glorified God. I asked the bishop, how can they glorify God? He had no idea, no question, no answer. So I wouldn't, never mind, because Christianity is for individual purpose. It is for your own spiritual uplift. You don't bother about other people. Let them go to hell. As Jesus showed by drowning 2,000 swine into the lake, he told that saint whom they have locked in the silence of the graveyard, don't worry. You don't throw pearl before swine. Let them do whatever they do, they will suffer. And that is why he showed them 2,000 pig was made to drown into the lake. And that is their fate. So here I'm doing the Gospel of St. John 15:1-8. Jesus said to his twice born laboring solitary brethren, and not the once born natural disciples of the rabbis. You know, they are 12 to 16 years old boys, you know, who used to come to the rabbi to learn moral laws or scriptures, who disciplined them through the moral laws of Moses. They did what their rabbis tell them. So, you know, the disciple, they do what their rabbis tell them to do. Thus Saul, being the disciple of Rabbi Gamaliel, did obey him obediently as required of him. He was a good disciple and persecuted the laborers of Jesus, but in his own heart, or subconscious, he was not happy. Thus, the substitute disciple is a corruption by the Messianic Jews to set up the same temple system from the yoke of which Jesus set us free by giving his own life as the Lamb of God. Are these robed, hireling, dog-collared priests in the churches of Mammon fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus, the anointed Christ of our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. I am the true vine that bears fruit for the new wine. You know, if you want to brew new wine, you have to be true wine planted in your heart. And my Father within me, you know, this is the temple of God. So where God lives, then in his own temple. So it's called Emmanuel. So me and my Father are one. Father within me is the wine grower, or maker of saints. Antichrist Pope is producing his own type, hypocrites. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit. Or in Jesus, we mend our ways that pleases our Father and not the general public as the politicians do. Politicians, what comes out of their mouth is pleasing to the voters. This is not what we seek. That is why the politicians are number one crook in the world. And everyone that does, he prunes so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word. Jesus had given them the word, you know. So they are already pruned. That means if there are any mistake or any doubts, he had cleared them up. That I spoke to you. Remain in me or keep on eating my flesh, which is called, he is our bridegroom, and he is in my heart, sitting in my heart. So I keep him with me. I eating the flesh of Jesus. As I remain in you, and I will look after you. That is, renew your inner man, which is Christ, every day. So when you have become solitary, you have got Christ in your heart. Then you need to renew it every day. Sometimes you make mistake, you correct it. With this Christ with small c, not with capital C. Capital C Christ is possessing the very Spirit of God, which is Holy Spirit with capital S. So we can make mistake. So keep on eating my flesh as I remain in you, and I will look after you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the true vine, our bridegroom. Christ Jesus is our bridegroom. True wine, our bridegroom, Christ Jesus. So neither can you unless you remain in me. If you remain in Jesus, then you eat his flesh, you understand what he is speaking, so then you can preach gospel in his honor after understanding it with authority. I am the vine, bridegroom. You are the branches, my virgin brides, called wives. There was a small parchment, you know, small piece of paper which the American found, over which it was written, Christ say, my wife. So they don't understand what my wife mean. So they were pointing finger at Mary Magdalene, that she is his wife. So he was having intercourse and had produced children. All that nonsense. So they are super donkeys carrying holy books. They go by the dead letters. In spirit, wife means that she is the one that feed you. Holy Spirit of our Father, God. I am the vine, bridegroom. You are the branches, my virgin brides, called wives. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. That means no Christ in your heart, no gospel. That is what I have written over here. Christ Jesus came to do the will of our Father, and not his own. So we remain as faithful saints of our Father, preaching gospel to glorify him in honor of Christ Jesus, our true vine. Anyone who does not remain in me or would not preach gospel as the Hallmark of our Father will be thrown out like a branch and wither. That means people who are You know, there are the branch which is thrown away is this one, and which Judas Iscariot was, he was thrown at the Last Supper. So these are, you know, the twice one who know, who are people of spirit. Evil, this is doubting spirit, sealed to serve God. So these are the branches, you know, sometimes they come off the true vine. They think they know better, and they form their own group, like these Latter-day Saint and Church of England, and all these things are formed by these people, you know, different sects. So they are the super blind people, you know. When they lead the blind, they fall into the sectarian riots. So anyone who does not remain in me or would not preach gospel as the hallmark of our Father will be thrown out like a branch, and wither. So it will wither also, you know, when you're thrown away, because you're not getting any food. People will gather them as in the sectarian riots and Holocausts, and throw them into a fire that will be burned. If you remain in me by keeping on eating my flesh and my words remain in you, when you preach gospel in honor of Christ called drinking the blood of Christ, or carrying your own cross as a solitary, ask for whatever you want, it will be done for you. By this is my Father glory. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my friends, as at the Last Supper that they had to hire an insider to catch the true Christ Jesus. Remember the temple priest, you know, Jesus was in the temple every day. He was earlier on in the temple. They saw him, everything. But all the 12 laborers of Jesus, they were speaking the same language. But they did not know who is the real Christ, you know. They said they will catch him at night when there are no tax collectors or other people who are atheists looking for gospel. So when they are asleep, then we will catch them. So that's why, you know, they sent Judas Iscariot at night to catch him, and not during the daytime. So I will leave it here. Yeah.